Hello, it's Monday, and automatically we are here to give to you TrendingSA. Yeah! We're coming to you live on SABC3, and we're also live online streaming, TrendingSA.tv. Hello, everyone. Good evening. I am your Madame Speaker. I am Babi Moloi. And I recognize you all, as well as me. I recognize me.
Oh, wow. I recognize those boots, baby.
Boots, girl.
You know what they say about girls who wear red shoes?
They don't wear anything underneath their trousers.
I told you I didn't like socks, obviously. I haven't worn a sock since my mom put socks on me.
Shame, that's weird.
No, it's weirdo. Sure thing. Hello, everybody, and... Oh, sorry, wrong part of the show. This is Nina helping me fix my cable.
I just want to put it back in the curtains where it belongs.
Hello, Nina.
Just like touching each other. That's what I figured out.
All right, so Nina, what's on your timeline today?
Listen, Pubby, I love you. All right, Twitter was lit all over the weekend. The hashtag I have never seen came up on my timeline. Peeps needed to be balanced on various issues, so I'll be checking up on this thread and showing you the things.
A cocky vampire, Nina?
Oh, yeah. This is, you know, everyone's always making like ridiculous faces on for their selfies. So
love
I was
it.
Like, this is sinusitis. Because I was like, these selfies are ridiculous. So this is me hamming up selfies.
That's we brilliant. Like it, Momo.
All right, on my right is our Momo with the files. Momo with the files. Momo with the files.
Yeah.
Momo with the files. It's Miss Goody Roberts!
Yeah, yes, girl.
Mama with the file. And then?
It was Friday, it was slipper day. I want to say thank you very much to Bobby Malloy for giving me her slippers. Yeah, nobody wanted to give me a pair of slippers, but Bobby Malloy gave me slippers. Thank you, Bobby Malloy. I'm nothing without you.
Hey.
Enjoy slipper day.
Who took that photo?
The amazing Nina Hasty took it.
You know what I'm saying? Just like
so you guys were hanging out on the weekend without.
Yes.
We did call you.
Yeah, we called you, but...
You didn't, but it's fine.
As usual,
the number you have
up.
Dialed. Yeah, but you know...
You don't want to accept reverse charges. That's your problem.
And, Kuli, what's on your timeline?
Oh, Mdasekai, the passing of South African iconic photographer, hashtag Usam Zima, was trending, and I'll be looking at the details.
Okay, fantastic. Next to her is our MCM, our physician with the mission. It's Dr. Musa Mtombeni. What are your Twitter diagnostics, Dagatella?
Well, what I'll be telling you today is that we'll be looking at the hashtag bad
what voice is this?
Moments. Twitter was lit before. As we check out what trended today, I don't want to turn around to see on the screen.
Oh, yeah. This is the second time she's come up in your pictures. Is there something that you'd like to face up?
No, there's nothing to say. That's just my friend.
The four heads are us.
Can we also talk about that long comment, spiritualist.duga?
I don't know what's going on.
This is how you get them when I'm with a Bible.
No, I didn't say anything. It's not even a... Like, my thing says Mother's Day at Mazo's. That's all I said. But
it's a beautiful thing that you guys did this weekend.
Yeah.
It was a beautiful thing. All right, so tonight's guest is for the ladies. He is an MCM. Some call him a Monday Motivation. He is a rapper extraordinaire. Ladies and gentlemen, K.O. is joining us tonight.
Yes.
Look at his step.
I want one of those hat things, but my head's too big.
A fez.
It's a fez.
I don't recognize your name, but your fez is familiar.
I like that.
It's not mine.
Very James Bondish.
Yeah. It was. Who was the one?
Dr. Evil.
Yeah, that guy.
Okay.
So, you can tag us on any of your questions for KO. On Twitter, we are at TrendingSA on 3. And on Facebook and Instagram, we're TrendingSA. And you can also use the hashtag TSA on 3. And now, we dance.
Yes, Daddy! What would you do? What would you say? What would you do? What would you say? Yes, I did. So I packed it up and brought it back to the crib. Just a little something to show you how we live. Everybody want it, but it ain't that serious. That's that. So if you gon' do it just like this. Did you realize that you are a kind of girl? You don't see just how wild the crowd is.
I miss the old Kanye.
I miss the old Kanye.
Before you were spewing nonsense.
Hi, Google.
Hello and welcome back. You're watching TrendingSA on SABC3. Right, so we love to get all of your Facebook posts, all of your posts on Instagram, even your tweets. We love them. Use the hashtag #ZaOn3 and they may be here on the screens or they might be read by one of us. And today, the us I will choose is your us.
You haven't done it in so long, sis.
I mean, you haven't read it in such a long time.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Zippy.
What's the name? What's wrapped in my blanket on a sofa with a cup of coffee enjoying the show? #ZaOn3. We love you, Charmaine.
Thanks, Charmaine. Yes, Charmaine. Yes.
No, Sisa Chia says, hey, guys, it's been too long. Guys, I had to cut a phone call so that I could focus on you guys.
Yes. You need that credit.
Dump him, baby girl.
Cut it.
Who gives the toilet? What's the current situation? I have a test tomorrow, but I can't miss the show. Love you guys. Buy me a Red Bull. Let's go! I don't know why I was so false.
So, guys, if I had a TV like that in my room, my parents would have given me a hiding if I wasn't studying. But anyway, I hope you pass.
Yeah, absolutely.
I foresee him or her passing.
Yeah.
I know.
As do I.
Mm. Yeah, they're clearly quite different.
How?
I...
Okay. Yeah. So,
what is the medical condition of...
Irish tourism.
Yeah,
thank you so much for all of the love. If you want to read your tweets across the screen, or if you want us to read your tweets, just like I said before, the hashtag is #ZaOn3, TrendingSA on Facebook and Instagram, and @TrendingSA3 on Twitter. Now, yesterday was the celebration of our dear mothers.
Yay!
Throughout the day on Sunday, people were sharing pictures, sharing warm and fuzzy words about their mothers on Twitter, and hopefully they phoned their mothers, unless their mothers did actually follow them on Twitter. The hashtag #ChampionMom started to blossom all over my timeline, and lots of local celebrities were not missing out on the action too, so they shared pics and beautiful words about their mums. We'll kick off with Skumba, who shared this picture of his mama and him.
Mom.
Not only is she a great mom, she is strong and she is a praying mom. She is a queen and a winner. #ChampionMom. That's really cool.
With a sense of humor as well. I've met her, she's divine.
Carol Shabalala, hey, saying today, like every day, I think of how blessed I am to have been raised by a queen, to be told that nothing is impossible. My beautiful mother truly raised a champion, and now I'm doing the same for my boys. Strong women raise champions. Yes, Carol!
Yes.
Oh, I love that.
Moshe!
I'll always stand. If it's a question of my heart, you got it. I love that.
I love that
song.
And beautiful Nomza Mombatha talking about her queen. Maybe you can help me out here with this.
My queen, ngiyabonga uthando lwakho, even when I'm... Okay, you can do the English.
Oh, thank you. Even when I make mistakes, you are quick with your forgiveness and slow in anger. I've watched you be confident, strong, witty, courageous, kind, and free. You've taught me freedom and courage. Raising champions, champion mom.
Nana.
Did you have a happy Mother's Day?
I had a wonderful Mother's Day for my mom. She was absolutely fantastic. Then it was all about me. I woke up, my daughter brought me breakfast in bed. And then, of course, it was an envelope with some money in there. Because we always give each other money, gifts. Yeah. So she gave me some money, and then I spent time with a boyfriend, then I spent time with my grandchild.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah.
Pops in.
I had a wonderful Mother's Day. I have a radio show in the morning, and so I'd forgotten to set my alarm, and my son's Mother's Day present to me was to kick me in the face at 5:27. I'm meant to be on air at 6. 5:27, he kicks me in the head. I woke up. I was like, thank you, my love. You saved my life. And then I got flowers from people who love me, and I was spoiled, and I went to a birthday party. It was just fabulous.
Nice.
But we cannot move past the Mother's Day craze on Twitter without mentioning one tweet that got people talking and the Instagram story to follow. The tweet, aka, also known as aka, posted showing DJ Zinze and their daughter Cairo.
Listen, Mumu. That child makes me want to have babies.
Calm down. Now, we don't know what it means, but tweeps have been speculating, you know, why would AKA tweet DJ Zintler?
How would they expect?
And this video, they're together with this little person that they created together.
They're a family.
It's a mystery. Ad Buyiswa had this to say. It's a bit of wisdom Buyiswa wants to share with DJ Zintle. Don't fall for it, Zintle. It's a trap. I don't understand what that means.
Being appreciated is a trap?
Let's see. I am Bonkosi SA. Ngena kanani kanani. Mega uzos. Upumelel. Uzo pumelel. Enter a little. Mega will
succeed.
Exit.
Succeed. Yes.
Enter, exit, enter, exit.
Direct translation.
Enter, exit. Ornette says, Queen B right now. Bring your pussy like a star, yum.
That is hilarious. Wow.
Listen, I think there's nothing wrong with supporting the mother of your children.
Babe.
I think it's wonderful.
They're family.
Through it all.
They're family. Yeah. They will always be family.
The fact that that's questioned is such a weird thing.
Yeah, the fact that it's questioned says a lot about our country.
Exactly.
It says everything, actually.
So well done, Kiernan, and well done, Zintle. And I hope you are just loving and loving and loving that beautiful little girl. So what's going on with you, Siskuli?
2018 has been a bearer of bad news, Mdasekhaya. It has been terrible. With many public figures passing away with only 5 months into the year, yet another legend has fallen. Photography journalist Usam Zima passed away on Saturday at a nail sprayed hospital at the age of 83.
Shame, man.
Usam Zima became famous for his photography skills, especially for exposing the cruelty of apartheid in pictures. Mm. His most notable image is the award-winning and iconic picture he took in 1976 of a wounded Hector Peterson shortly before he died during the June 16th Soweto uprising. For a bit of background on how the famous picture came about, here is a video of Sam Zima giving some details about the day he took the picture.
The country was that we're not allowed to take pictures of anything that the police have done. So I knew I was risking my life. The last picture that I took with this camera is by Hector Peterson in June 16, 1976.
Wow.
Amazing.
Wow. After news of Sam Zima's passing spread, the hashtag RP Sam Zima, as well as hashtag Sam Zima, started to trend as fans and admirers of Sam's work took to social media to share their last words about the legend, the legendary photographer, of course. Here are some tweets. Ulrich Janse van Vieren says, your pictures did so much more than tell 1,000 words. They changed history and they changed the future. IRP hashtag Sam Zima. Usa Saida RSA says, this man, hashtag Sam Zima, took this iconic photo during the trying times of liberation struggle. He exposed the brutal apartheid regime to the international community for killing innocent children. I have so much respect for this man for his brave action. May his soul rest in peace. Salute. Well, first, do no harm says, hashtag Sam Zima's legendary picture was first published in the South African black newspaper, The World. Although this image is said to have generated over 27 million, he saw very little of it because he didn't own the copyright until 1998. He also says that this picture ruined his life. And of course, we found out that apparently the picture ruined his life because the apartheid regime was after him, after he took the picture. And they were harassing him after the picture got the popularity. Of course, our collective hearts are heavy with sympathy, and our thoughts of comfort and condolences are with the grieving family of Baba Sam Zima, the legend.
Indeed, Sis Kuli. Thank you. Look, I'm going to take it onto a lighter social media note and talk about the happenings. This weekend was all kinds of saucy and spiced up. Tweeps are created. Guys, you know, I don't know where you come up with this stuff, but hashtag I have never seen. There were rave reviews about it for those that followed and retweeted the hashtag. Peeps were sharing funny realizations of things that they'd never noticed or paid attention to before. So let's have a look. Spuda something, Kaze says, I've never seen a South African going to Somalia or Pakistan to open as bazaar.
I've never seen a South African going to Somalia. Has he been to Somalia or Pakistan?
Well, that's a good question.
Has he been to his bazaar?
They're everywhere.
They are in the same WhatsApp group. All right. And then Tiban SA says, I have never seen a person stopping an ambulance just to ask what happened. Why would you do that? Oh, I'm sorry to interrupt this man or woman almost dying. What's wrong with you?
No, that's dope.
Hey, people need real jobs, eh? Shawnee_SA says, I have never seen a black family that doesn't cook rice on a Sunday.
You need to get out more, Angel.
You know, I know a lot of white families that also cook rice on Sundays. Hashtag just saying. Lord God Wavy says, I have never seen drunk people in alcohol adverts. This one.
This is actually facts only,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I've never seen, like, say, the drunk uncle. Who was a drunk uncle.
Yeah.
With, like, Chibuku styles. You know,
Have you seen the adverts? Yes, it's always some guy in a six-pack walking in the field. It's like, no.
How do you keep a six-pack drinking beer?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, they don't drink beer on set. You do know that.
They should just do ads with, like, they drink, like, apple juice and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
They should have, like, snack beans on some, like, yes,
I didn't.
I drink this. This is the best thing ever. I love this stuff. It's the best. Bottles! All right, then. BBTM says, I have never seen a ZCC uniform on a washing line.
It depends where you live when a BBTM.
No, but you know what I was thinking? But maybe they, like, when you're getting baptized, it gets washed once. All right, so, and then Malisela Setati says, I've never seen vinegar adverts on TV. I thought about this. Have you?
No.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Okay. And then Demande 9 says, I have never seen the kids we're donating to Rand for at KFC. Now, I laughed at this when we originally read through it. And you say you have.
Well, I was an ambassador for that brand for a little while. And we went to the children's homes that all that money went to. And the actual beautifully put together homes where children who would ordinarily not have anywhere to live and school and eat and all of that are fed because of those plus two rands.
Oh,
so
really?
It's okay. A real thing.
Okay. Cool.
Nice.
Okay. Well, thank you all very much for watching so far. Let's take a quick break. Lots more to cover after this, our ad break. TrendingSA on SABC3 and online on TrendingSA.tv. Don't forget that later on in the show, superstar rapper KO.
Yes! Sorry.
So post any questions that you have for him by tagging us at SABC3 and at TrendingSA on 3. And you can also use the hashtag #ZaOn3. Musa, you've got some social media for us. Boom.
Yes, so we are checking out the posts right now. And this is what you have to say to us. Travis Miller saying TrendingSA on 3, first time watching and loving the show. The heaters must be on in studio.
We're hot. We don't need heaters.
Let's laugh harder. Maybe we can generate some body heat.
Yeah, I know. All right, let's check out. Oh, Batu. All right, this one from Otwa Olel was saying that I have never seen my post on trending. Say,
and now,
well, there you have it. Congratulations. Thank you for all.
How do you feel about wasting your one opportunity?
You know what I mean?
To have your tweet
by complaining.
Does that mean,
Joe Askies? But we'll find him again. No?
Yeah, one day is one day. Maybe if you post more, we'll post you more. Thank you for all the posts, likes, retweets. We like seeing them right here on the screen, and of course, we like reading them too. Starting things off though, we're gonna take things on a light. So, no, Twitter was lit before popped up on my feeds today when tweets were remembering the good old days when one tweet could say it all. You had 140 characters instead of all these memoirs that people write nowadays.
That's funny.
Had this
so
to say.
Funny.
Starting things off by saying Twitter was lit before this followed Train Tontoni. They be all over the timeline. That face, guys.
Sorry, that face is so much.
Mona Lisa looking like Mandla.
Nananas.
Mandla Lisa.
All right. And then others join in on this one. And this is what they had to say. This one coming through from Emily T saying that Twitter was lit before people who need anger management classes join and started taking their frustrations out on us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very roly eyes of that vibe. Another one here coming through from Hope, well, Mlaba, saying that Twitter's lit before MTN and Vodacom had clapbacks. Now, this is what the actual message is looking like. This one from Letitia.
Letitia.
Ah, Letitia is fine.
Letitia.
Yeah, okay, fine. Then.
Oh, it's Letitia, Letitia. All right. Saying MTNZA really upset. *141# confirms I have airtime, but I cannot make any phone calls. Data and airtime disappears. No response from emails. Oh, going through a lot there, babe.
Letitia.
And then a fake MTN South Africa account went. That's sad. At least we still have the land.
That's terrible. I'm sorry, that is very
sad. Letitia, thank you. And then another one here. From Malume Shepard saying that Twitter slipped before people started asking for retweets to go out on a date.
Right.
I mean, just be a man. Just be a man.
And what?
And
you
just
take 50 Shella. Cent here, you take another 50 cent there, you got $1. Be a man.
Be a man.
Do the right thing.
Now, you know, come to think of it, recently a lot of things have escalated quite a lot on the internet. People now request, you know, retweets so that they can get on dates with somebody. Guys, just balance with this. I mean, look. You can't be that desperate.
You can't.
Who's your girlfriend, Musa?
This woman is beautiful.
And your other girlfriend.
Sure, who's this?
She wants RTs.
These are Musa's flavors.
So hang on. So what do they want RTs for? What's
I don't even know.
Balance me.
This one. How many RTs for a date? 50K. Oh, what, babes? Oh, 50K before, sorry, that was personal. 50K before the 20th of the month. Guys, it really isn't that hard. Just say you love them and that's the end of it. Full stop. Moving on to another hashtag. Of course, looking at the Hawks and hashtag mosque attack appeared in the timeline after an attack on a mosque that happened in Verulam, north of Durban last week Thursday. Now, a group of men stormed a mosque rather, on Thursday afternoon wearing half balaclavas and they went in. It may sound a bit graphic, so if you're one of those sensitive people, close your ears right now. They slit the throats of a worshipper and then stabbed two other congregants. Now, the attackers are said to have sped off in a white vehicle, and on Sunday, the unidentified vehicle, or rather identified device, was found at the mosque. And today the Hawks confirmed that the bomb hadn't been detonated. Now, obviously no one has claimed responsibility for this as yet, but it's believed that it is some sort of extremism that's got to do with this. Investigations are underway and troops are a bit frustrated because there seems to be a lack of urgency with all of this, especially after, you know, people being injured as well as the bomb. And of course, Fake Beirut jumped in on this one and weighed down, saying that the Hawks are very useless. They're now saying that they're busy trying to find out what chemicals were used in this bomb. I guess that's going to take forever, maybe 2 months. Now,
please
we'll see.
That in Beirut's voice.
Yeah, I know. I don't know it. Automatically, the Hawks are useful. Did they even deactivate the bomb?
Useless, Chomi.
What did I say? Useful.
Useful.
No, but they might. Sometimes they're useful.
Okay, no. Good.
Yeah, no. I was just in case they try to investigate me. All right. Another one here coming through from Craig Jenkins saying, no comment. Remember how long the Hawks took to investigate state capture tender fraud as well as money laundering against Zuma and the Guptas and the CEOs of state-owned enterprises? Needs a genuine crime-fighting unit. Not the Mickey unit.
Mickey Mouse.
It's a mouse.
Where's the mouse?
Like a computer mouse.
Okay,
we're here to help you, no?
Thank you, ladies. I appreciate it. And the last one here from Mbule saying that the Hawks do not inspire.
Mbule lo sit. No, I'm joking.
Yeah, they've said what they had to say, and I guess we'll have to find out and see if the chemicals that they use in the bomb are actually the chemicals that they're supposed to have, because there's so much going on there. But that is the update for the day.
Well done.
Nice one. Thank you.
Thank you for all the help, guys.
Musa, he's our man. If he can do it, no one can. Go, Musa.
Thank you, ladies. I appreciate it.
So, from bad walk rides to bad high school moments. Ooh, it was all over my timelines and my feeds today as tweets shared moments from school, which made you feel like you could make like Harry Potter and disappear. You can't see me anymore.
We can see you.
Okay. At Elanyoni started it off with this tweet.
Oh no.
Musa, meme of the year. Okay, listen. Bad high school moments when the teacher posts our test results at the assembly hall for everyone to see. Oh, Elanyoni underscore. At Andile underscore Mavusa essay, bad high school moments being sent by the teacher to your crush's class.
At least Steve and Musa wearing
bad high school moments. Your school called today, J underscore dollar.
You look so cute. Listen, lest we forget those goody two shoes, those teachers' pets who always did their homework on time, had neat handwriting, and they were the teacher's favorite, putting everyone else under pressure. Like Emily 8 learned the hard way that being a star student doesn't always bear good fruit. Take a look at her tweet. Musa. Bad high school moments when you lied to your squad that you didn't write homework and then they see you submitting.
What?
Is my friend Zoe looking like an actor. Right. And then... That was kind of funny. Musa.
Betrayal. I'm telling you that. Well, sharing is caring. And then there were those moments when you're just looking forward to love. But then, Bushola then went on to say this in the tweet. Bad high school moments when you give him a, do you love me?
Oh.
Yes or no? Tick a box. Bese iti no. Wow.
I sent one in school, right? I sent one. And he colored all the three block boxes in. Yes, no, okay, and maybe.
Wow.
I was like,
it needs to be a man and make a decision.
Yeah, man.
What? Come on, man. But then look, I think the absolute worst moment in high school were those encounters with the bullies. Mm-hmm. Look what happened when it's Senti decided to jump into things, saying that bad high school moments, receiving that letter. Asihi nawe. And you did not bring lunchbox or turen for Amakuinya. Wow. That's a bit rough. Now, speaking of bad high school moments, I want to switch things up a bit. DJ, do the things there.
Did you just shout at the DJ in the sky?
Now, ladies. To all the bullies that are here with us today,
preach.
I'm here to preach. It is time. Time to confess. Time to repent. I say confessor, I say repenter, I say confessor, I say repenter. Yes. Say it with me now. I say confessor, I say repenter. If you were a bully in high school, this is your time. If you were a bully in high school, this is your time.
Go on with it, sister.
Preach, sister.
Go on with it, sister.
Preach, sister.
Go on with it, sister. Be brave, sister.
Oh, guys, I can't do this in American accent. It's just that when I was in standard 10, the form ones were at my mercy. And I used to just kind of bully them a little. I used to make them do push-ups.
Oh.
When I walked into assembly in the morning, I would make them make sure that they were shorter than me, because though I was a prefect, they had to be shorter than me when I walked into assembly, Lord.
Gracious bully.
Yeah. I was a bully. Amen. Amen.
Woo!
Can I have some tea now? Sorry, I'm sorry about that. You know, they come up to me all the time.
Uh-huh.
And they're like, even though I'm watching your stand-up comedy show, do I still have to duck down?
Yeah. Now, we'll move on to another sister. Are you ready to repent?
Is it you?
Are you ready to come?
Is it you?
Okay.
It's a puppy. What did you do?
It's you. Step forward, sister. Step forward, sister. Repenter.
I'm ready to repenter.
Hallelujah.
Repent with a moment.
In the house of repentance.
I'm ready to repenter.
Yay.
Get on repenter.
Yay.
Mini-winnie.
No. This music, Leon, please. Okay. I have something to tell. A story to tell. Not a good story to tell.
Oh, yes.
It's not a good.
Amen, sister.
It's about the pain that I felt.
The pain
from being bullied by sisters like you, although you yourself I forgive.
Okay, thank you.
I was bullied because my hair fell out in school. And then here, I just had like a bald spot. And then there was this boy called Clinton, and he was standing in the line and assembly, and he said, Bobby's got a bald spot. And then the whole school laughed at me.
Mm.
I'm so sorry. That's terrible.
Well, thank you for that, sister.
I'm so sorry.
And now it's time to repent and a confessor, bully. Are you ready, my sister?
Yes, my brother.
Are you ready, my sister? Yes, my brother. Let's hear it, my sister.
I was never bullied, my brother.
Okay,
they stayed away from me, my brother. Yes. They said I was weird. I used to crush cans, my brother. I sat there and crushed cans, and they ran away from me. I was never bullied. They ran away from me. I crushed.
Thank you, sister.
Why are you crushing cans?
It was my thing. I was from Cape Town. We crushed cans.
You are such a weirdo.
I thought I was weird. Wow. And you, Musa, we know about you. Musa in a bus once said to us.
Oh yes.
There were these girls.
Yes.
These girls were smoking in school. Ugh, I didn't like those girls.
Yeah.
So you were the bully.
No, I was the prefect. There is a big difference between a prefect and a bully.
No, but you enjoyed it too much.
I was a prefect too.
Law and order, but you were one of those bad prefects.
There we go, bullying again.
Yeah. Wabon, judging.
We're ex-prefects.
Bullying. But listen, I mean, jokes aside, bullying is a very serious mm-hmm. problem in our schools and even in our work environments. Bullying can be a huge problem. So please, please, if you are being bullied, if there's somebody who's hiding anonymously behind their cell phone screens who is bullying you on your social media, speak up. There are many, mm-hmm. many organizations that can intercept and get involved even at the school level, mm-hmm. you know, and HR practices also make sure that you are protected. So do not suffer alone.
Guys, don't forget, the workplace is included. It's also an issue that needs to be tackled.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can crushing.
Oh, Lala, you should get the crabs.
I don't know if we want to start the story again, so we're going to take a very quick ad
break. Are you
bullying
me?
Sort of. It's time for an ad break. Trending is there on three.
What are you doing with the crabs?
Call me your swagger, no. Casanova, I like how she call me your swagger, no. We run in the city for sure. Officer pretending my love was with the love. She wanna come to the crib with the bar.
That's so hot. Okay, so you know exactly what time it is. Do you know? It is TrendingSA on SABC3, and it's time to get into our guest for tonight. Talented, amazing, but Nina's going to tell you more about him.
In case you weren't listening carefully, listen properly. By the way, that song that we were playing, that was the official new song, Swagger Nova, even though I think I was the first person to play it on radio. But anyway, KO is arguably one of the best rappers in South Africa. He first entered the music space under the hip-hop group Tear Gas over 13 years ago. Then, when things, you know, went, you know, awry with the group members and the record label, he branched out to do his own thing. Where we heard him release, guys, you know these songs. Mission Statement, Son of a Gun, Scandala, Kara Kara, which is one of the few rap songs to reach 3 million views on YouTube in South Africa. KO has now got 2 solo albums and a clothing line, which I cannot wait to talk about, under his name. And tonight, he's here to chat with us about being Mr. CEO and his journey as a musician. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome platinum-selling, multiple award-winner KO!
Don't give a fuck if you hate us. I get on the record and none of you niggas can fuck with the cadence. I can't so much.
I haven't seen you in so long. My gosh.
Hey.
Sweet. Cool.
Well, welcome to our show. It's good to have you here.
Total honor.
You're my fave. Have I told you that before?
I appreciate you. My fave too.
Listen, congratulations on the move to Sony. Was that in the works? Were we expecting that?
We actually had a relationship with Sony through Cash Time because we were distributed by Sony. So after the whole Cash Time debacle, I just went in there and had a direct relationship with them. So the deal is my music is being released by them directly. Mm. And I also have an imprint of my own, which is also Scandal Republic. So that and everything that I do is going out through the Sony platform.
You've always been very savvy when it comes to the moves that you make in this business. And not a lot of people know that you studied PR.
Yeah.
Where did you study it? Val?
Yeah. VUT.
At VUT. At what point did you go, okay, cool, I'm not going to promote other people, or was it a decision beforehand, say, I'm going to go and study PR because I'm going to go and do rap? Or, you know, what came first? When did you know I was going to be a rapper and I'm going to apply everything that I learned at Varsity to make myself this monster superstar?
It was actually just like by coincidence because I came up to Joburg all the way from Mpumalanga to pursue music. But the only way I could come up here, back in the day, if I had told my folks that I wanted to come up to Joburg for music, I probably would have been still stuck back home. So they said, the only way you're going up there is if you go to study. So that was my getaway ticket. So I came up here and studied, and by default, while I was there at campus, I met up with my homies, my EN, Dugza, and that's how we became an outfit together. But shortly after tear gas, I decided that, seeing that someone had given me an opportunity to get into the music business, they ushered me in. So I might as well, you know, do the same and open the door for other people. And that's how Cash Time Life was born.
Right.
You know, so it was just my way of sharing my blessings and you know what I mean? And blessing other people with them.
Nana, talk to me about being inspired to be a cop by your mom. What happened to that industry and that career?
Well, it wasn't necessarily like her inspiring me to do it. At the time, actually shortly after varsity, unfortunately I struggled with getting a job, right? So here I was with a qualification, and just going through what, you know, ordinary young people go through in this country. So the one opportunity that came about, you know, she sent me an application form. There's, you know, these guys are actually accepting new applicants. So you might as well just slot in and give it your best shot. So I did that. And the day I was supposed to go to do the interview, it was the same day when we had our first meeting at the record label where we got signed.
Oh, wow.
So I'm sitting there. It's a Monday morning. I'm like, do I go that way or do I go that way?
Literally a fork in the road.
Hey, so I had to obviously go to the record label because that was my passion. I didn't tell my mom about it right away. I only told her a couple days later that, okay, so I ended up not going. And obviously she was disappointed because she didn't know if this music thing was going to pan out at all. So by the grace of God, obviously things played out the way that they did.
That's amazing. Grace does play a big part in it. And when you follow your passion, the universe kind of conspires to make everything work for you, to teach you or to give you success. And so I want to speak to KO, the businessman, right? I'm sure you started in this business, like you say, with passion.
Yeah.
But then you know, were the platform that so many people's dreams were pinned on. And then with Cash Time, things started, you know, breaking down, moving in directions that you didn't like. Nomuzi left, you know, other artists as well. I want to know from you, what was unexpected? What were the things that shocked you the most about the entertainment business?
I'd say whatever that I did, you know, it was done from a great place. You know, I don't, even till this day, I don't have any sort of ill feelings towards anyone or whatever, because I did that just purely out of the kindness of my own heart. I decided to open a door, and when it came to a point where people started peeling off, unfortunately, I ended up getting the short end of the stick because it was made to look like people were purely moving based on the fact that KO didn't want them to blossom, you know. And instead of being, of people actually standing up on their own two feet on some, bro, that is not actually the case. We are leaving because we want to go pursue other opportunities. So it was, some people took comfort in the fact that people were just like blaming me on that level. So broke my heart. I remember one time I went to my brother's house the day things were just like, you know, unfolding. And I shed a tear because I didn't see that coming. I thought that, like, being that I was genuinely great towards people, that I was going to receive the same, you know, genuine support even when we are not actually doing business together anymore, you know. So that was just like the only disappointing part, but we grow from these things. So we forge ahead.
I know this seems like a redundant question, and I'm sure you're asked this a lot. Is there a chance of Tia Gas getting back together? Seeing as Bongo Muffin have gotten back together, is there pressure on you? Everyone's like, next, who else is getting back together?
You know, it's kind of annoying where on Twitter, a lot of the time, people put it across as KO, make it happen.
Yeah.
KO, and we need another Tia Gas album. Mm. Do it. You know, it's not entirely my call. Mm. We are a collective, and there's no leader. We are all, you know, equal. So the issue with why things have taken so long is because shortly after we started the whole Catch Time thing, unfortunately, the relationships amongst ourselves as the outfit, the Tear Gas outfit, amongst the members, unfortunately, the relationship got a little disenfranchised. You know, so the bond and the connection wasn't entirely there as much as it was when we were working on, you know, the four albums. Mm. So if we were to do it now, I solely would prefer it to be on an organic level.
Yeah.
Instead of it, of us just like going to the studio just to cut a check, because it will come across in the
music.
It'll
sound like that.
People were like, maybe they shouldn't have. You know, done.
But are we saying, you know, this relationship cannot be repaired?
No, we're not saying that. Yeah, nice. I mean, we are. This year, I mean, I've had, you know, slight conversation with Dugza, who is the one person that I actually hadn't been, you know, in touch with.
Okay, much, nice.
You know, but hopefully, you know, as things progress, and we'll see how, you know, things unfold as the year progresses. But I'm hopeful that, you know, one day we will get to that place when we can recreate the magic again.
Now, a few years ago, Scandal Republic gets released, bang after bang after banger. And a few years later, which is quite recently, you think Scandal Republic 2. So what inspires the new one?
The new one actually just came, it was largely inspired by the adversities that I endured after the collapse of the label, right? Because that came with, unfortunately, challenges where my brand stood at the time, and I endured a bit of depression as well. So I had a lot of time just like doing some reflection, and I decided to use the music as a therapeutic exercise to let off steam and stuff like that. So when you listen to it, you'll get to know me just like beyond just who I am. I'm also a human being, you know. You'll get to see me being vulnerable and expressing my feelings, and, you know, wearing my heart on my sleeve for the first time, because it's something that I've never really done. It's always been just like this guy who is unfazed and, you know, nonchalant in how I do things. So with this album, you get to really see my heart and get in touch with who I am as a person.
So we've got 1 minute left. We want to talk about a few things. I'm going to keep you after the break, but I want us to talk about your fashion label.
Can we please? And I need that. Small, medium.
Make that three.
This is a one of one, but we're working on putting out, you know, a line of these.
Good.
You know what
as
I'm
soon
saying?
As possible. It's cold.
Yeah.
And we don't mind. We can afford to buy your things.
Ah, not give us the money. I can't afford me.
I know this, but it's actually available. Some of the items are available at a store called Fashion Crawl, downtown Johannesburg.
And that hoodie, that's yours too, no?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. All of it.
You can order anywhere in the country. You can simply just go on the website, fashioncrawl.co.za, and place your order. Or you can just literally go there in person and purchase it yourself.
All right, so you're going to stick around with us after the ad break. Yeah. KO everybody on Trending SA. We'll be right back. Has been heard by all. This is Trending SA on SABC3, and just like that, our Monday show is almost done and dusted, but we've still got our wonderful guest in studio, KO everybody, and we've got some viewer questions for you, don't we, Nina?
We do indeed, Pubby. That's right, Pubby. Raja Kampir asks, TrendingSA on 3, want to ask Mr. Cash Time, when is the ghetto episode video coming out? Can't wait for that. Ish, nami.
I'm actually in the process of working on my next album.
Okay.
And on Hush Hush, I might have a new single dropping next month.
Ooh!
Already featuring someone. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that will actually happen, but
a video.
That song is one of the pillars of my last album.
Okay.
So it's timeless. You know, it's not something that I want to rush. So I might just even decide to do a video for it after the single comes out or whatever, you know. So yeah, that's what happens when you do make timeless music.
I like that. It stood the test of time. All right, next one. Vuyo Simao says,
Vuyo.
Is he performing at the FC Barcelona game versus Ngizwe Beshu Umamko Bosi
Ekasi?
Umamko Gobosi.
Neither confirm.
Oh, that's a yes.
Ah,
critical but stable.
Critical but stable!
I've got a question. You've got to give me a yes or no. You are so fun. You are so incredible. Love your brain. Love your music. Do you have a better half? Because
of course I do.
Hey, I've got my own person.
Is this like a... Is
I think that's where that conversation is.
All right. No, you don't want to give us more? You don't want to give us more? Are you married?
What
are
no,
you? We have I been put married. Into place. Oh, is that her?
No. Yeah.
All right, guys. KO, thank you very much for being here and for being so honest and sharing
private
your music with us. Thank you all for watching on this Monday. Hopefully, we have lit up your screens. Thank you to the people who are watching on this. No, I'm joking. Our glam squad over here, Shem. You guys work so hard, Yazi. And thank you so much to you for watching. We're back on your screens again, 10:30 p.m. right here on SABC3 with more social media trends. Good night, everybody.
Why are we saying this? Nani was easy, Nini, okay, Bella Nana getting better. 07, but the lady king, better. Pulli potter, I give a kiss, and again. Nalu Teru Funang in this, okay, Taylor went to washing, we never back. Get to the bed. I do your coat and go.